your heart belie. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. To us once more. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. Hang the shining star upon the highest bough.
David Taubenfeld, the night is not about me, but I happen to be both an officiant and the groom's father. And I'm going to just tell you, there's a few reasons why I'm here doing this tonight. The first is I was the low bid. The second is they had four or five other people in mind. They all turned out to be avid Texas or OU fans, and they didn't want to risk it, given this. The third is we had a very specific amount of seats here, and there was one too few, and I agreed to do a stand-up job. fourth and second most important is that Casey, for the last 6 years, has insisted on calling me Mr. Taubenfeld. And I've objected to that the whole time, trying to correct that. But from now on, every time she calls me Mr. Taubenfeld, I get to call her Mrs. Taubenfeld. The number one reason, though, that I'm doing this is who is there who is an officiant who's better suited than me to know how much these two are ready to be married, how successful the marriage is going to be, and how much they love each other. And I'm going to just talk a little bit before we get to the vows about how they may not realize it, you may not realize it either, but they've been close most of their lives. Casey went to Merriman Park Elementary and Weston went to Wallace Elementary, just a few miles apart. They were a year apart in age. So there they were, think about it. Him in third grade, her in second grade, a few miles apart, frolicking at recess. Then she was in the freshman center a year after him, and then in high school they both played soccer a year apart. In high school she was also just the girl in the other room or coming in and leaving while he was doing stuff with John Mogk, her brother, who was his Weston's best friend. So they were on the periphery that whole time. And then he went to Trinity and got his engineering degree at Trinity in San Antonio. And she went to UT in Austin. There they were, separated by only 40 or 50 miles there and still a year apart. And Weston at Trinity got his engineering degree, took a semester off and went to Spain and came back and still got his engineering degree on time in 4 years, which is very rare. And Casey was a recruited walk-on at UT played soccer there and got two Pac-12 championships. She has two Pac-12. Big 12 championships. You know, once you got the ring, it doesn't really matter. But then Weston had an adventuresome stroke and went off for a year in Nanjing. Casey went to grad school where she was number one out of 750 of her class in grad school at UT. She sat for the CPA and passed that on the first time she sat for it. And Weston is an engineer and has been an engineer at the same shop here in Dallas for how many years? 6 years. 6 years. And Casey has been at Maverick working as a CPA here in Dallas for 6 years. 6 years as well. And so they were close. They were always close and hovering around. And then about 6 years ago, on that fateful dark night. Y'all remember that dark night? It was actually Dark Knight Rises. And it was a movie with Batman. It was a Batman movie. That was their first date. Casey wasn't even sure it was a date until Weston bought her dinner afterwards. but it was. And from that dark night on, that it was, you know, kind of boring. Date after date. Then suddenly Facebook status changes. Date. And then, you know, whereas most people have this notion of put a ring on it, theirs was a little bit different. Theirs was put a second bathroom in it. Weston had a house and it was kind of a bachelor pad and it had one grungy bathroom and he really wanted Casey to share it with him and she held out for a second bathroom and now it's got a beautiful second bathroom in there. It's been remodeled. And so here we come forward, date, go to a bunch of marriages all over the place, marriage. And then, everyone who knows Casey knows she's a Christmas girl. And so lo and behold, a year ago, Weston proposed some Christmas lights on this house with the new bathroom in it. And Casey said yes. And here we are a year later, and they still love each other as much as they did then. And with that, Will, Casey's young brother's got a passage to read from a book we all know.
So this is from 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
And see, that's why that book has been a bestseller since the printing press was invented. And that's what I it seems like I've known Weston since he was born. And I've known Casey for a long time too, and I can just tell you they do have that persevering love. And so now without further ado, let's get to the ideas. Weston, repeat after me. Casey, I love you. I want to be your other half, and you to be mine. I promise to depend on you and to support you. We are good together, and we will be good together forever.
We are good together, and we will be good together forever.
Casey, repeat after me. Weston, I love you. I want to be your other half, and you to be mine. I promise to depend on you and to support you.
I promise to depend on you and support you.
We are good together, and we will be good together forever.
We're good together, and we'll be good together forever.
All right. Did someone happen to buy some rings? Oh, good. You know, there's a lot of, as you can tell, I don't stand on tradition very much in doing these wedding services. I forgot, actually, I was going to tell you, if there is anyone here who knows of any reason these two should not be married, I'll be at the reception, just come and see me then. But the rings, everyone knows, they're bands and they never end. But what I think is great about the rings is if you just lay them on the table, it's a bunch of metal, circular metal, and frankly, you know, wedding rings are, generally speaking, relatively plain. But when they're placed on the finger, the void in the middle of the ring is filled. And that's what I think of as the symbolism. These are, when they place these rings on each other's fingers, the voids that are in their lives will be filled. So, Weston, do you take Casey to be your wife, to love, to support, to empower, and to enjoy your time with forever?
Yeah.
Casey, do you take Weston to be your husband, to love, to support, to empower, and to enjoy your time with forever? You may kiss. Well, here they are, Weston and Casey Taubenfeld. Oh, there's the ring on the finger. I forgot to fill the void. All right, here we go. There they are.
I hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood. Crazy, everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on.
Listen, baby. Continue to do that because you're going to have a great life together. And I'm just thrilled to have you as a son-in-law, and I'm just so glad the decision you made. And just remember, I get to keep Landry anytime you go out of town. So thank you.
Casey and Weston on this momentous occasion. So I am Mandy McCune. I am Casey's matron of honor and one of her many best friends. Tonight, I would like to send my congratulations to both of you on this step in your this next step in your relationship. While some people may see this as the last step to solidifying your bond, I'm here to tell you that the best is truly yet to come. Many times, a bride and a groom walk out of their reception without taking a moment to breathe it all in. So I encourage you to look out to your audience right now and take this moment in. Each and every person in this room is here to celebrate the start and continuation, depending on how you want to look at it, of your life together. Take a moment to let all of this sink in. You both walked in here as separate individuals, but tonight you will walk out as one unified force, as witnessed by all of us here. For the past decade, I have known Casey and had the privilege to have her as one of my best friends. We've grown together, we've learned together, and we've had some truly amazing adventures together. Even though she is still a longhorn. I promise I'd keep this short, so I'd like to leave you both with this. Be kind to one another and love each other fiercely every day. Life goes by quickly, and before you know it, you will be celebrating your 5 and 10 year anniversaries. And as someone asked me to remind you, remember to keep the ups and downs in the bedroom. I love you both. Congratulations to Casey and Weston.
This story was when I was 7 years old and got woken up told I was going to go to the doctor. I mean, I was going to the hospital because my mom was having a baby. And I was very excited about it. And I got this big, giant bag of toys to play with. And I was like, man, having a brother is going to be the best thing ever. Little I know that was the last bag of toys I was ever going to get. Second story is, when Weston was about 3, and he really did terrorize me for a long time, I was in a grocery store, and I was walking up an aisle. It was around Halloween time, I guess. I don't know. I know there was tridents on one of the store aisles because I turned around, and one was going full speed at my eye and into my eye. It was pretty successful. So he wanted to get rid of me for a long time. And then when he was, I think, in first grade, the teacher asked one wish that he could have, and his wish was to have sharp teeth. And I'm pretty sure it was so he could eat me. But now I do have a fourth memory, seeing Weston look at Casey, look into her eyes, and they're going to marry, and knowing that he's going to be happy, and they're going to be happy together for the rest of their life. It's good to finally have a good memory.
So, I don't know if everyone knows me, just for a little bit of context, Weston and I met in the 80s through mutual friends. Well, friends. And he was just a different person back then. He didn't have a job, he was still living off his parents. Since then, he's actually matured quite a bit. And I want to tell a couple of stories that mention just a little about how he's matured. So, the first story is what kind of brother he's been. And the last one is Manny is now. So here's the kind of brother that he is. So I don't know if you know this, but Weston and I spent some time in China. And once in China, we were in a KTV. This is a big, very expensive karaoke place where everybody has their own room. A couple of things allegedly occurred, and we found ourselves speaking with Chinese police officers. We were in the back of a dark room with Chinese officers, and everything was in Mandarin. To be clear, actually nothing had gone wrong, and we had done nothing. But some liquor had gone missing. So we tried to explain it to them, but we just couldn't explain it to them in a language that they could understand. And it became very clear to us, only one thing could happen. We had to escape. We were being led into another dark room when Weston had a stroke of brilliance, truly a genius's mind. He walked a little bit slower than everybody else. And then at one point, he just disappeared, like magic. And after this, after Weston had Shawshank Redemption his way out of there, he did one thing as soon as he got out. You know what it was? He jumped back in. He ran back into the fire, because I was still in there. Weston had to go back and save me. Even after his stunning escape, and he escaped from the madness, Weston jumped back into the danger zone to save his brother, because that's how much he cares about family, because that's the kind of man he is, and the kind of father he'll be. That brings me to the second story. So Weston and I have lots of stories similar to one I just told. Stories that are sweet, cute, kind of funny, but actually a little dangerous. Weston and I were hanging out, we had been drinking a little bit, and we were having a good time. I thought we were having a good time. And he looked me in the eye, and he had this look, and it's the look that I realize he gets when he's about to say something devilish. We're about to go on another journey. He's got some fire pushing him to say whatever he's about to say next. He looked me right in the eye, and he said, "I miss Casey." So I asked them both on Wednesday, I said, "What 5 things do you love most about each other?" And I want to go through and say what those were, because they don't know what they said about each other. So first, Weston. I can't tell you the first thing Weston said, so we're going to jump to 5 after. Weston said, honesty, eyes, athleticism, passion, intelligence. He then said, "More personally, I love the fact that she cannot tell a lie. I love the way she laughs at my jokes. I love that she's always willing to try anything athletic, even if it's playing on my men's soccer team. She knows and has actively planned for any future, so no matter what happens, we'll be ready for it. And finally, when she's taken on a commitment, she's always going to kill it. My words, Casey, please don't kill my brother." Y'all ready for Casey's? So I said, "Casey, what five things do you love most about Weston?" She said, "His kind heart, his intelligence, his looks, his athletic ability, his humor, his honesty. I think he's gonna be a great father one day. Are you guys counting? I think he's gonna be a great father. He's tough." Sorry, he thinks he's tough. "But he's actually super sensitive. He puts up with my craziness, and he's always willing to help me out, even when it's inconvenient." She said, "Finally, he loves Landry." And then she said, "Actually, finally, I love that he's willing to do anything for me. One time, it was freezing outside, so he gave me his t-shirt, literally off his back, so I could wrap it around me, and he walked home shirtless. He also has given me his shoes, so I didn't hurt so much walking home in heels, and I walked home barefoot. Sorry to the men in this room." And she said, "That's just the kind of person he is." Then she hesitated. I know this via text because she wrote dot, dot, dot. And she said, "Maybe that's the kind of person I am. I shouldn't have let him walk home barefoot." So I want to end it with this. I read a story once that asserted that the real reason people end up in long-term relationships, it's not because of the character traits you say you're looking for. It's not because you're of a great level of attractiveness or equal level of attractiveness. You know what it was? They said it was proximity. And I say, you look at Casey and Weston, and you say, that's perfect evidence. It's proximity. They were close together. They went to high school together, and here they are. But here's the thing. It may be true that they both went to the same high school, but my big brother, he moved to Spain. He moved to China. He's been all over the world. And he came back to Dallas. He came back to Casey. It may or may not be true that people end up with someone more based on proximity than anything else, but my brother has traveled the world. He's met literally thousands of people all over the globe. And he only realized after all of that travel that his perfect match was always right here. Proximity may be helpful, but true love is everything. Thank you so much for being the thing that Weston misses, even when he's hanging out with me. And thank you so much for finally taking him off my hands.
I just wanted to take a second just to say thank you to everybody that's here. I thought that maybe I'd plan a speech, but then I thought maybe thank you would be enough, but I've said thank you so many times over the past month, year, that it feels like it's gotten old before we could fully show the appreciation for everything that everybody's done for us. So we're here. I have to say personally thank you to Casey's parents who put this awesome party on for us. And just as importantly, thank you to everybody that's here tonight and for everybody that's been there for us all of our lives. This is, of course, one of the happiest days of our lives. And, I don't think that something this special or awesome happens without enough people helping you through the hard times. So on behalf of Casey and myself, thank you so much for every compliment, for every drink, for every moment that you've been there for us. And thank you for every kind word. And just thank you for being here for us. So we love you all. We really do. So
drink up. We'll see you on the dance floor.
Oh, hey.
conscious ways to whatever song plays, without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here wearing the weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. She's pulling at me saying, Dad, I need you. There's a ball at the castle and I've been invited, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms, 'cause I know something the prince never knew. All too soon, the clock will strike midnight, and she'll be gone. She says he's a nice guy, and I'd be impressed. She wants to know if I approve of the dress. She says, Dad, the prom is just 1 week away, and I need to practice my dancing. Oh, please, Daddy, please. So I will dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms, 'cause I know something the prince never knew.
Unforgettable. In every way. Get me out, boy. sing the country song. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy. Nothing you can make that can't be made. No one you can save that can't be saved. Nothing you can do, but you can learn how to be you in time.
Won't, but I bet you won't. all through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine
how I'm feeling so many ways.
There's something I want you to have.
Oh, it's beautiful. But wait a minute, isn't this?
Yeah, yes it is.
But I thought the old lady dropped it into the ocean in the air.
Well, baby, I went down and got it for you.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
Smooth skin, you say you wanna get in my bins? Well, use me, cause you ain't that average groupie. I seen her dancing, to hell with romancing. She's sweat, wet, got it going like a turbo vet. I'm tired of magazines, send flat butts all the thing. Take the average black man and ask him that. She gotta pack much bags. So, fellas,
yeah,
fellas,
yeah,
has your girlfriend got your butt?
Hell
tell
yeah,
her, shake it,
shake it,
shake it,
shake it,
shake
it,
shake that healthy butt. Baby got ballet.
Blazing fire, all you ever did was wreck me.
I've been trying to do it right. I've been living a lonely life. I've been sleeping here instead. I've been sleeping in my bed. I've been sleeping in my bed. So show me family, all the blood that I will bleed. I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong. But I can write a song. I belong with you. You belong with me, you're my sweetheart. I belong with you. You belong with me, you're my
take my heart.